This week, we're at the mouth of the Okanagan River on the Columbia River in north central Washington for sockeye salmon. And then we're heading 500 miles downstream to the mouth of the Columbia River for some Buoy 10 Chinook salmon action. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. After traveling for many hundreds of miles up the Columbia River, most of the system's sockeye salmon end up here, in the Okanagan River, which eventually takes them into Canada. It's not surprising, then, that the mouth of the Okanagan is a hotspot for sockeye fishing, which has only in the past few years reopened as a sport fishery, after successful enhancement projects. Today, we're after these sockeye salmon with Bob Schmidt and Bobby Loomis of Mack's Lure, who are fishing with Mack's Lure Pro Staff member, Richy Harrod.
We've got four rods out. We've got one on each downrigger, and then we're fishing lead rods out the back. The lead rods will put us down at the same depths, but you get a little bit different type of movement than you do off of the downrigger. So we're fishing all virtually the same type of gear on every one of them, other than some different colors to see what they're hitting this day. You know, every day is a little bit different.
What we've got rigged up here is we've got a little smile blade for traction in front of the Double D Dodger, a little leader to the Cha Cha Sockeye, and a little shrimp on there for some extra bait and traction.
Well, we're here on the Columbia River, just in the pool above Wells Dam near Brewster, and we're at the mouth of the Okanagan River. This is kind of a wide part of the Columbia River where the fish kind of stack up before they go up the Okanagan River. And Bob and Bobby here have just put the gear down on the downriggers and on lead weight. And we're fishing in about 58 feet of water right now, and fishing anywhere from 20 to 26 feet. Yeah, I'm surprised we haven't got bit yet. You know, this has been a really good year so far. The fish have been really stacked in here, and at times we've just been catching fish after fish. So it's a little slow this morning, but it'll pick up. Fish showing up here on the depth finder. We're going through them right now. And a lot of times we'll see them on the depth finder like this, and then you know, you watch the rods in a couple minutes when the gear goes through it. Of course, what you're seeing here is where the boat is, but as soon as the gear goes through where the fish are, that's, you want to start watching.
These fish, you know, we talk about kokanee and how finicky they are and how they turn on and turn off. Well, kokanee are a landlocked sockeye. And these fish, it'll be like somebody turned the dinner bell on and all of a sudden something clicks and they'll just go off. And they'll bite for a certain period of time and then they'll shut off. And it's a matter of that's why we raced out here and got out here as early as we could. Just because of the fact it gives you a little more time on the water and you find those fish that are biting at that given time, you know, in that area. So we're trying to find the biters right now. This rod bit.
Net or lift, Bobby?
I'll lift it.
Okay. Or not.
The lead rod
okay.
In?
Nope.
Good.
Only put it out to 18.
18.
Nice little fish. Well, we're messing around with the depth for a long time to find out where those fish are at and the ones that are actually biting. And you got to play around with it a little bit. Once you find that depth, then you run everything at that depth.
Well, we were finally got the downrigger just about 18 feet, and so we were just trolling downstream actually this time. And actually, we've been finding that we get quite a few bites on the downstream troll.
That fish hit a one of our new Cha Cha Sockeye rigs that we've been building, and it's basically a glow-in-the-dark squitter, silver smile blade on top with our double D dodger. Taking these coon shrimp and making 2-3 baits out of each one. So all you're doing is just getting a little bit of scent and the color on there, and it does a lot of movement along with the smile blade as well as the dodger.
You can see the smile blade in front of the Cha Cha Hoochie skirt there. Will almost come to a dead stop and then speed back up and slow down. And that's that stop and go action that double D dodger gives it. And it's the same sort of action fishermen try to get when they make those S curves and those X patterns to trigger the fish. When they make that S curve at a slow down, they come out of it, it speeds back up, and it'll trigger those strikes. And that is a constant action you get with that double D dodger, even though you're going in a straight line.
Welcome back to Brewster Pool on the Upper Columbia River in North Central Washington. I'm Justin Walford. Bob Schmidt, Bobby Loomis, and Richy Harrod are starting to get into some good sockeye fishing, which is the new hot fishery in this area, with big numbers now returning after decades of no sockeye fishing. After the building of Chief Joseph Dam with no fish ladder decimated the sockeye run. But the sockeye aren't the only fish now available here.
Is that a Chinook Jack?
Yeah, it's a Chinook Jack. A jack or an immature adult is considered a fish under 24 inches.
Well, we're really fortunate right here in this area, because you could potentially get a limit of 22 fish here. You can get 6 sockeye apiece, you can get 10 triploids, and you can get 6 Chinook. And so this is a really good fishery right here, and you have the potential of getting quite a limit in a day. No way, Richy. Really?
Richy.
Triple right here, Bobby. Lost it. Came off right there.
Net.
Had a lot of action going on there. We thought all 4 rods went out, but actually the one rod got crossed with the other fish line, so we had 3 takedowns though, 3 out of 4.
Well, so far our normal catch ratio has really been kind of almost 2 to 1. I mean, it's not unusual to lose about half as many fish as that you actually catch.
Fish on.
Kick it out of gear real quick. Or...
These sockeye salmon, despite being over 500 miles from the saltwater at the mouth of the Columbia, are outstanding to eat. But like with any salmon species, it's important to keep them cold. And most people prefer to bleed their fish right away.
And one of the things that we always do is when we put the fish in the box, we make sure that we bleed them. And the way we do that is we just rip the gills. And it'll really help, you know, in the quality of the meat.
This is stuff that we're fishing with is the sockeye, the Cha Cha sockeye squitters, and they're rigged up with a 1.5 inch or a 2 inch squid body, beads in between the hooks, 1-0 hooks, and a smile blade. Run a short leader to your dodger, so you get a lot of movement out of it.
Got it, fish on. Ripped that right out of the downrigger clip himself. That was a hard hit.
Bobby. Good job.
Yeah, we caught that one on the white, and I'm going to change out the other rod to a white.
That's been
the one that we've been doing the best on. We've got about an 8-inch leader, 9-inch leader to the squitter, and between your squitter and dodger. And what it does is it gives you a tremendous amount of movement out of the dodger itself, which is what really winds the fish up.
Sockeye fishing on the Columbia has only been open to sport fishermen for the past few years, after many years of no fishing. So in a way, most people are really just learning how to fish for sockeye for the first time and to take advantage of the incredible new runs.
Well, what brought this run back was the collaborative effort between the Canadians and the Colville Indians up here. And the sockeye actually run up the Okanagan River. Nothing can get past Chief Joseph, which is another 10 miles up the river from here. There's no fish ladders or anything over that dam. So the sockeye actually go up the Okanagan River and up into Canada, into the lake up there. Go through Asuyas into the next lake. And they brought this whole program back. 3 years ago was the first year that we were able to fish it, and we had like 200,000 plus fish in here. And the fishing was just absolutely fantastic. This year, they didn't realize they were going to get this many back, but as of to date, we've got over 520,000 sockeye over Bonneville Dam, and most of those fish are coming up here. You've got a few that go into Idaho, very few, and then you've got a few that go up to up to Lake Wenatchee, and you're talking 50, 60,000 fish out of 520. So you're talking about a pretty good amount of fish, and this fishery never existed before 3 years ago. So it's absolutely fantastic. I mean, you got people coming from California, Nevada, Arizona, coming up here just to fish this sockeye fishery.
I knew that would be interesting with that net.
It's all right, it's in the boat.
My first salmon ever.
Hey, it was? Right on.
You don't need a bunch of fancy equipment. Anybody can come out here and do it. It's great.
Just downrigger showdown.
That's right.
After we finished this day, Bobby cooked up a few of these salmon, and they were great. I'm not sure what type of seasoning he used, but if you're curious about a good way to cook sockeye, you might email Bobby at bloomis@maxlure.com. And if you have any questions about getting rigged up for sockeye or about any of the Max Lure products, you can call during business hours or visit their website at maxlure.com. When fishing the Upper Columbia, a great place to stay is the Pateros Lakeshore Inn, with hookups for boats, dock facilities, and comfortable rooms overlooking the river. Start to plan your trip with a visit to PaterosLakeshoreInn.com.